Hello, my name is Gradius, and a great man named Carl von Clausewitz said that in war, more than anywhere else, things do not turn out as we expect. Join me as we discover the lessons to be learned in the weird, odd, and sometimes crazy military engagements in unusual battles of history. Today's battle is quite the interesting one as it features Americans, French prisoners, and Germans helping each other to fight off SS troops in a medieval castle, in what was probably the last battle for Nazi Germany in World War II. The setting for this unusual battle is in the sleepy little Tyrolean town of Itter. The castle, called Schloss Itter in German, has been around since about 1204. It passed into the hands of many different nations over the centuries until Germany got a hold of it during their Austrian annexation in 1938. The Nazis started using Castle Itter in 1943 as an SS POW camp. The castle was to hold VIP prisoners, where they could live in decent luxury until they could be used in the war effort. Most of the VIPs were French, whose names included Albert Lebrun, the former French president who was ousted by Pétain, Francesco Saverio Nitti, the former Italian prime minister, André-François Poncet, former French ambassador to both Germany and Italy, Jean Barota, a famous French tennis star, and several other French politicians and prime ministers, including a Yugoslavian political prisoner named Zunomir Kukovic. Generally, life was easy for the captives in the castle, as they had free roam throughout the interior, and the guards, who were transferred there because they were too old to fight, were seen as fairly friendly to the prisoners they were guarding. As 1944 rolled around, food shortages were seen in the castle. Come 1945, with Germany's defeat imminent, the SS started using the castle as a stopping point on their way to escape the country from the victorious Allies. For some, Castle Itter was their final stop. One example was Edward Witer, the last commander of the Dachau prison camp, who committed suicide while at the castle on May 2, 1945. 2 days after Witer's suicide, the commander at Itter decided it was time to leave, and took all the guards with him, leaving the French prisoners in control of the castle. Seeing that the time was ripe for rescuing, the Yugoslavian Zunomir volunteered to sneak past the SS troops in town and get help from Allied forces in nearby Innsbruck. Zunomir managed to sneak past the SS, and on his way, he encountered a German infantry unit led by Major Gangl. Gangl, who wanted to surrender to Allied forces, knew he would be looked on kindly if he rescued the French prisoners in the castle. And so he dispatched Zunomir to Innsbruck, while he and 20 other Germans in a Kubelwagen made their way to Kufstein to locate some Allied troops. Zunomir encountered some troops from the 103rd Infantry Division and enlisted their aid, while Gangl found the 23rd Tank Battalion led by 1st Lieutenant Jack Lee in Kufstein and got their aid to help as well. So, with 20 German soldiers under Gangl, 14 American soldiers under Jack Lee, and 2 Sherman tanks, the small force made their way to Itter. On a bridge to Itter, they did encounter some SS troops trying to establish a blockade, and proceeded to run them off. Leaving 1 Sherman and 7 soldiers to guard the bridge, Lee and the rest of his ragtag force made it to the castle by nightfall. Knowing that the area was crawling with SS troops, and that they didn't have enough vehicles to transport themselves and the prisoners to safety, Captain Jack Lee decided to bunker down in the castle with the hope that his men could hold out against any attack while waiting for reinforcements to come. That evening, SS troops assaulted the castle with the intent on eliminating the French prisoners and their American counterparts. Sporadic rifle fire lasted from 11 p.m. until dawn, when the SS decided to attack in force. Machine guns fired into the castle windows as a German Flak 88 lined up its sights on the lone Sherman tank guarding the castle entrance. 1 shot was all it took for the tank to explode. Luckily, the crew managed to evacuate their vehicle before it was destroyed. With the tank gone, the SS troops made a general attack on the castle, all the while taking considerable losses from the stiff resistance put up by the Americans, Germans, and French prisoners' rifle fire. The Flak 88 was still firing, and had already killed several of the German defenders. One of the dead was Major Gangl, who was killed by a sniper while attempting to spot the 88. Meanwhile, the 103rd Infantry, under Major John Kramers, who had been directed by Zunamir to the castle, reached the bridge where Captain Jack had left the spare Sherman and seven of his men to guard it. Major Kramers could hear the battle in the castle, but was confused as to the best way to get there and assist the defenders. Unable to reach the castle by radio, the Major simply found a telephone and called the castle. Captain Jack, in response to the call, ordered the tennis player Jean Barotra to run to the bridge and lead the reinforcements to the castle, which he succeeded. With their ammunition running out and the SS pressing their attack, Captain Jack decided there was only one thing they could do. He, along with the surviving American and German soldiers and French prisoners, would barricade themselves in the castle and fight hand-to-hand if the SS breached the door. The SS sensed victory and pushed towards the castle keep. One soldier hoisted a German rocket launcher and was just about to shoot the doors down when one of the SS soldiers cried out, "Amerikanisch Panzer!" The reinforcements led to the castle by John Barotra and under Major Kramers had arrived. Under pressure, the SS cut their losses and pulled out, and thus the Battle of Castle Itter was over. There were two things that made this battle so unusual. The first is that this is the only battle where American, French, and Germans fought together against a common foe in World War II. The second is that this battle occurred 5 days after Hitler committed suicide in Berlin, so it is entirely possible that this is the very last battle for the Third Reich in World War II. The battle did get press attention in a July 1945 edition of the Saturday Evening Post, and in 2013, a writer named Stephen Harding was inspired to write a book about the incident called The Last Battle. As a last note, an interview was conducted with Lieutenant Jack Lee in 1973, just before he passed away. When asked what his thoughts were about the whole incident, he simply replied, "Well, it was just the darndest thing." This has been another episode of Unusual Battles in History. Thank you for watching.